In the 1930s, the Austrian-British philosopher Karl Popper noticed that some academics were reckless when using data to explain how things worked, while others were far more careful and depended on experiments to prove their ideas. For example, many early psychologists, like Sigmund Freud, would claim that a patient's mental illness was caused by something without any real proof, while more careful scientists would rely on evidence completely. When the famous physicist Albert Einstein published his general theory of relativity, he was determined to make sure his mathematics were correct through an experiment. He knew that if his mathematics were right, during a solar eclipse, the sun's rays would shine around the moon. If his mathematics were wrong, they wouldn't, and he would have to reject his theory. Karl Popper noticed how vital this willingness to reject a theory based on evidence was, and concluded that real science must be falsifiable. In other words, any legitimate scientific claim must be able to be proven incorrect or falsified. Popper went one step further and said that a genuine scientist does not seek to prove their theory, but instead to reject their theory. By thinking this way, scientists can protect themselves from getting wrapped up in their desire to succeed and focus on what is correct. Most science done since Popper has relied on falsification as the gold standard, but some fields of modern science now focus more on matching observation with data due to experimental limitations. But emerging science that no longer perfectly follows Popper's idea still follows his goal to be as careful as possible when making claims about nature and to always be willing to be proven incorrect in light of new evidence.